Now to animate this view, go to plot control, select animate, deform plus undeform result. So this way we have successfully animated our result. So hello guys and welcome back to our channel Simple Random Knowledge. So guys, in today's video we are going to see how to perform stress analysis of simply supported beam with uniform distributed load. So guys, this is the image given in the question. We are supposed to find the bending moment diagram and shear force diagram for this figure. We have the value of E and value of PR, and also we have the value of cross section of a beam. So guys, before moving towards our video, there are around 80% of people who are watching this video but they haven't subscribed to my channel. So I genuinely request to all you guys that please do subscribe to my channel and press the bell icon near it. And if you have not watched the previous video, then I will post the link in description as well as in I button. So without wasting any more time, let's start with today's video. So guys, this is the user interface of NGCPDO software. So first of all, go to file and select option clear and start new and select do not read file. Click on OK. And NGCPDO will ask your permission whether you want to execute this command. So click on yes. So guys, using this command, NGCPDO clears all your previous project data and provides you new fresh window. So guys, as we know, in any experiment, we have some pre-processors, solution and general post-processing steps. So same user interface you get in this NGCPDO software. So guys, first of all, we are going to set our preference. So select option preference, select here structural and then click on OK. Now we move to the preprocessor. So click here element type, click on add, select here add again. Now we are going to perform this experiment on beam. So select here beam, select here 2 node 188 and then click on OK. Now we have defined our element type as beam. Now close this window. Now go to material properties, select material model, select here structural, linear, elastic, isotropic. Now in the question we have the value of EX and PR. So write here the value of EX as 2.1 E11 and value of PR as 0.3 and then click on OK. Now close this window. Now go to section, select here beam, common section. Now we have the value of cross section given in the question. The value of breadth is 1 and value of height is 1. Click on OK. So you can confirm these values. We have the value of cross section as 1 by 1 meter and we have the value of E and V as 2.1 E11 and 0.3 respectively. Now go to modeling, select here create, select here key points, inactive CS. Now first key point will be on origin. So keep all the settings as default and just click on apply. Now second key point is on 12, 0, 0, so click on OK. So guys, if you are not able to see your key points that you have created, there might be chances that you have zoomed in this window. So to get these key points back, just click on this option, fit view. So here you can see we have able to see these key points that we have created. Now go to lines, select your option in active coordinates, select key point number 1 and key point number 2, click on OK. So this way we have connected these two key points. Now minimize this line and minimize this create. Now we move to the meshing part, select your size control, select your manual size, line, all lines. Now we are going to divide this line in 50 division. So write here 50 and then click on OK. So here you can see this line is divided into 50 divisions. Now we are going to mesh this line. So minimize this line and go to mesh. Select a line, so you will get this kind of window. So at the bottom you will get the option of pick all. So select here pick all. So this way our line will get meshed. Now minimize this meshing part. Now you go to loads. Now select your analysis type, new analysis, select here static, click on OK. Now go to define load, select here apply, select structural, displacement, on key points, select key point number 1 and key point number 2, click on OK. Now we are not going to restrict all degrees of freedom. We are going to keep this rotation along Z as free. So click on OK. Now minimize this displacement and go to pressure. So scroll down, you will get the option on beam. So again at the bottom, you will get the option pick all. So using this option, the NGCPDO will select all the 50 divisions that we have created. Now load key is 2. And pressure value is 100. click on OK. So here you can see we have successfully applied the uniform distributed load on our simply supported beam. Now minimize this pressure and structural. Now this way we have completed with our preprocessors. So minimize this preprocessors and go to solution. Select here solve, current LS, click on OK. So here you can see we have successfully able to run our solution. So close this window and close this window also. Now we move to the general post-processing steps. So select here general post-processing steps. So as we know in question, we are supposed to find bending moment and shear force diagram. First we are supposed to define element table. So select option define element table. Go to define, select add. So here scroll down by sequence number. Now we are going to use four sequence for defining our bending moment and shear force diagram. So first sequence is 3, click on OK. So we have got some warning that requested database is not available. So close this window and close this window. Now how to resolve that warning? Just go to result viewer, select here DOF solution, X component, and just close this window again. So using this step, you will be able to resolve that warning. So again go to define table, select here add, scroll down, select by sequence number, specify the sequence as 3, click on apply. So here you can see we have able to define this element table successfully. Now again go to by sequence number, define our next sequence as 6, click on apply. So follow the same method and define our third sequence as 16, click on apply. And last sequence is 19, click on OK. So here you can see we have defined our four sequence which we are going to use for getting our bending moment and shear force diagram. Now close this window and close this element table. Now go to plot result, contour plot, line element. Now we are going to use that sequence that we have defined. So at the position of node I, keep the sequence as 3, and at the position of node J, select the sequence as 16, click on OK. So here you can see we have got our bending moment diagram. So instead of clicking the screenshot, you can save this image by going to plot control, select hard copy, select to file, select file format as GPEG and click on OK. So this image will be saved in your folder. Now follow the same procedure. Now in the place of node I, select sequence as 6, and in the place of node J, select sequence as 19, click on OK. So here you can see we have got a shear force diagram. So for getting the image, again go to plot control, go to hard copy, to file, select file format as GPEG and then click on OK. Now this way we have got our bending moment and shear force diagram. To get a deformed shape of this beam, go to deform shape, select deform plus undeform result and then click on OK. So we have got our 2D image of our deformed beam. So for getting this 3D image, go to plot control, select style, size and shape. So here the display of element, click here on, click on OK. So here you can see we have got a 3D image. Now this is the side view. To get this isometric view, select here isometric. Now to animate this view, go to plot control, select animate, select deform shape, deform plus undeform result, and then click on OK. So this way we have successfully animated our result. So guys, this animation video will be saved in your folder. So guys, this way we have completed with our today's experiment, stress analysis of simply supported beam with uniform distributed load. I hope that you have liked this video. Please hit that subscribe button and press the bell icon near it. And if you have not watched my playlist on finite element analysis experiment, then I will post a link of playlist in description as well as in I button. So until our next video, stay safe and happy learning. Thank you guys.